broadcasting across America and around the world.
Such a name, are you talking now?
Live from our studios in Sumter, South Carolina.
What's this?
You're listening to PowerAndPraiseRadio.com.
Tuesday, Destiny listeners. Happy Tuesday to you. Welcome to our show of Destiny Talk with your host, Lady Luella Cook. This is our hour of inspiration, motivation, and activation towards your destiny. I pray everyone has had a beautiful day thus far, as I have. And so I'm excited about what Christ is doing in my life, as I hope that you are excited about what he is doing in your life. Did you know that in Christ we can do anything? We can do all things within the will of God, which is purposed for your life. The will of God is purposed just for you. How successful we are when we understand the benefits of living a righteous life. We have access to the righteous life. We have access to victory. So tonight's show is about hashtag I am victory. Victory is more than a slogan to me. It's about my purpose statement of who I am in Christ. You know, the Bible declares many times that we as believers of the Christian faith are victorious. We are declared winners. Our show topic and discussion will lead us into the Word of God, declaring the victory, declaring that you can win, declaring that you are victorious. Great is your reward when you overcome life's problems and walk victoriously in Christ. And so tonight we will have a discussion about that. So grab your pen and your notebook. Let's have some destiny talk. After the song break, we'll be back with the scripture of focus.
Blow my mind. Blow my mind. Blow my mind. Do the impossible. Blow my mind.
Blow my mind, God.
Blow my mind.
We want to see your hand, God.
Blow my mind. To the impossible.
Eyes have not seen. Ears have not.
Blow my mind.
Blow my mind.
You lift just one hand and just say that into your own atmosphere. Blow my mind.
Blow my mind.
We want to see miracles done, yeah.
Blow my mind.
Do the impossible. The good news.
God can do anything. God can do anything.
You gotta believe this.
Certainly God can do anything. You know, songs like that just takes me back. And when I listen to songs like that, if I'm having that kind of a day or having a day where I need my spirit lifted up and I can hear a song of victory and I can pick up on a chant of victory, and my soul will receive that God can certainly do anything. And if God can do anything, he's my master. He's the one that I serve. He's the one that gives me the breath, the reason why I'm living. Then that certainly does something for me. And so it calls me to put myself in check, to know that the victory that I am proclaiming on the show that we're talking about, the victory is certainly ours. So God can do anything. Let's take a listen to one of our scriptures of focus on tonight. It will be coming from Galatians 2 and 20. It happens to be one of my favorite scriptures. And it says, I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ that lives in me. God is so good to us that he has given us victory over sin. And if we go into the book of Romans for a few more scriptures that will actually solidify who we are in Christ, since we're saying that it is no longer I, when we become a believer of the faith, when we become a believer of Christ, it is no longer us, it is no longer the I, but it is Christ, the light that shines within us. And so if we look into the book of Romans, Romans 6 and 34 declares, oh, do you not know that as many of us as were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we were buried with him through baptism into death, that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in the newness of life. In other words, when Jesus died on the cross, and I know we just went through the resurrection season, when Jesus died on the cross, we died with him. There's power in knowing who you are in Christ. Romans 6, verse 6, knowing that our old man was crucified with him, that the body of death may be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves of sin. We must know that Christ died for us and that we are no longer a slave to sin. You got to put that thing into perspective. You got to put it into perspective so that you would know that although we are tempted and temptations come and sin is ever present, we don't have to be a slave to sin, because when we know that Christ died for us, who died for us and he went to the cross for our sins, the blood was shed for our sins. When we put that into perspective, it helps us know the power of who we are. It helps us know that we have power over the enemy. We have power over the devil. We have power over addictions and strongholds and generational curses. We have power over those things that used to drive us when we were living according to the flesh. But when we become born again, when we become saved and we receive the newness of life, we receive salvation, we walk in Christ, we live by Christ, we live in him. It's because of him that we live and we move and we have our very being. It's who we are, and it becomes evident in our works. It becomes evident in our, in our actions. It becomes evident. Let me give you some more good news coming from Zephaniah, the 3rd chapter in the 17th verse. This is good news here. It says, the Lord your God is with you. He is mighty to save. He will take great delight in you. He will quiet you with his love. All you got to do is just think about it. Just think about it. He will rejoice over you with singing. This verse is so reassuring and refreshing to me, as I hope that it will be to you. If we just look at what it is saying here in more depth, it's saying that he will rejoice over you with singing. So in other words, let me point out two things about this scripture. The first thing I want to point out is that it's saying that the Lord your God is in your midst and you are a victorious warrior. Don't worry about it, because he's mighty to save. He will save you. He will rescue you. That's the first thing. The second thing is that it settles any mental defect or defense that comes up against your mind and your knowing who you are. So there are times that we're going to get stuck in our circumstances and our situations, believers just as well as non-believers, those who we are, you know, hoping to reach by, you know, empowerment through the word of God, that God is mighty to save. But yes, because we are in this world, because we do live in a fleshly body, there's going to be times that we're going to come up against some trials and some tribulations. There's some times that we're going to come up against some things. There's been times that I know that we can recall that we may have lost the battle to our flesh. How many times have we been defeated by our old sinful nature? Okay, how many times have we fallen and wondered if we would ever get back to where we were before? So in other words, you know, there comes a time where there are going to be things that's going to happen that's going to, you know, trigger some things maybe in your mind or make you feel like, you know, you are defected. But God, who is mighty to save, he will take great delight in you regardless of where you've been and what you've been through. He takes great delight in who you are and who he know that he has created you to be. And that is, he has created you to be victorious. He's created you to be called victory. You have victory over sin. And so another good point here, which this is a word about winning, because, you know, you can't call yourself victory and live the victorious life without having the mental capacity somewhere to believe that you are a born again winner, that you are a winner in life. And so there are several stories in the Bible that I can recall that, you know, some of the warriors or the fighters, the ones who, you know, had to go before and fight, you know, battles and had to intrigue into some things where we know that the enemy may have taken a portion of their mind to make them believe and to feel that they were defeated. If we look at Joshua, I think about Joshua, the king of Jericho, how he 40 years after God had led his family out of Egypt and through the desert, the Lord had been speaking to Joshua, and the Lord spoke to Joshua, and he told him to go to Ai. And God promised Joshua some things. He told him some things would be different. He assured Joshua and Israel that they would have the victory. So no matter what Joshua saw, or no matter what he may have been feeling, you know, in his mind, God says to Joshua, he said, "Fear not, I have given into thy hand the king of Ai and his people and his city, plus the land. And thou shalt do to Ai and her king as thou did unto Jericho and her king." The reason Joshua destroyed Jericho was because when God told him to do it, Joshua trusted that God had a plan for him. And he did it. But not in his own strength and his might, but because of his obedience to the word of God. Because God told him, "Fear not, I'm going to give you the victory." So to those of you who might be listening, if you've fallen and you feel that you've lost the battle to the flesh, I say to you, fear not. God will give you the victory. God has made many promises to his children, and not just small promises. I'm talking about big, tremendous blessings, promises. And they all are wrapped around the same notion, the same thought pattern, the same truth, that we don't have to live in defeat. We don't have to live in defeat. And that's the word about winning. Don't live in defeat. And if you feel stuck, don't stay there. You pull yourself up by the word of God, by the fear not that's in the Bible. I will be with you. My word will comfort you. My word will keep you. God has made promises to us that assures us that we are no longer slaves to sin, to the flesh and the devil, but that we triumph over the devil. We can triumph over the flesh. For in Romans 6 and 14 it says, for sin shall not have dominion over you, for you are not under the law, but you are under grace. Come on, we serve a graceful God. We serve a graceful God who is rich in grace and mercies. Another great promise that he has made in 2 Corinthians 5 and 17, he tells us that we've been made new creatures in Christ Jesus. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. All things are have become new in who you are, because your old nature has died. But the spirit of life, that is what resides on the inside of you. That's where your newness resides. You know, that's your newness in life. That's your new take on things, if you will. We have been given the divine nature, another one of his promises, whereby we are given unto us, that has been given unto us, exceeding great and precious promises, that by these promises, that these promises that are given to us, we are partakers of the divine nature. And that's 2 Peter 2 and 4. You can read that in its entirety. But it's telling us that we've been given great and precious promises of divine natures. And another thing is, we are indwelled by the Holy Spirit. I don't know about you, but that makes me feel mighty good when I know that I have to come up against some things, when I have to face some giants. And we'll talk about facing those giants in the Matters of the Heart segment. But when you have to come up against, the giants and the things that may, make us fearful. Because I do understand that there are some things out there, and there's some things that we have to go through, and we do become fearful of them. But again, that's why we have the Word of God. That's why we have the Word of God, to connect to the, if we're connected to the Word, if we're connected to the vine, then he will give us, you know, he will give us what we need. He will give us that strength when we need to triumph through, when we need to know that this word is going to help us battle over the fear that is trying to overtake us. Fear can overtake you physically by the way of stress. It comes in variations of symptoms and, you know, all kind of things. I know we're in the month of May, and, we are educating the Lady Cook Ministries. We're educating on the mental health awareness form, and we'll actually be doing that next week in Columbia. But we want to make sure that we educate one another. You know, there's things that the devil sends by way of symptoms and different, you know, fear, stress, that weighing on you every day and not having an outlet, not asking someone to pray for you, or you being able to understand or pray for yourself. Those things, the devil is trying to take you out. He's trying to take you out. But we have to, we have to do enough and care enough about ourselves to be able to locate ourselves and be able to talk freely about those things that we know that are weights for us, that are putting a burden on us, that are weighing heavily on our heart and against us. We have to reach out and talk, and we have to be unified. Those are just some of the topics that we'll be talking about, the spiritual foundation of the church, and how can we be free to express these things that we do experience, because it's no longer, you know, the hush topics or anything like that. We have to be about our Father's business and building up one another and building healthy families again around the cornerstone in the community, which is the church, which are those who serve in the fivefold ministry. We are the voice and the vessels of the Word of God to go out and to allow it to flow through the anointing that God has placed on our lives to reach his people. And so we have to know the truths, and we have to know the great promises, of God. So, you know, Destiny listeners, whatever the circumstances you find yourself in, however things may look, and despite all the problems that, you know, might confront you, always remember that God is with you and that he is in control of your circumstances. And I say that again, God is in control of your circumstances. We must learn how to walk through knowing the victory, the crown, and the cross was for our lives. He did it just for you. He did it just for me. The Lord didn't give us salvation or leave it for us to feel defeated or to walk around as defeated, you know, foes beaten and enslaved by the flesh. No, we're no longer slaves to the flesh. We are free. We are liberated by His Spirit. We are liberated. And so that's why we are victory. He saved us to set us free, to enable us to walk in the victory that He gives to all of those who walk according to His word and according to His word and His will. Let's further our discussion after the next song break with Matters of the Heart.
You met me deep in my despair to show me you would never leave me there. You claimed me 'cause I was made for so much more. I am your child and I'm worth fighting for. So heavy with the weight of my mistakes you carried me and refused to let me sink under the pressure you meant for me to soar. I am your child and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard all you have planned for me, and nothing can separate me from your love when there's so much more still worth fighting for. Now I'm moving by faith and not by sight towards victory. By the power of your might, you're straightening out my path, opening every door. I am your child and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen,
nothing can separate me from your love
when there's so much more.
Some things are worth fighting for. I have a few more scriptures that I want to share. I call them my scriptures of victory. And I like to have the word of God, especially when we know that we're talking and we want to develop the mindset of winning, and how we stay victorious and how we walk in victory. And, you know, it can be a struggle. some days. And so when we, you know, fill ourselves up on the Word of God, when we feast and we feed off the Word of God, it's good to know where to find the scriptures. It's good to know to recite these scriptures. So I have a few more that I want to share with you. 2 Timothy 4:18. The Lord will rescue me from every evil attack and will bring me safely to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. The Lord will rescue me from every evil attack. Hebrews 7:25. Therefore he is able to save completely those who come to God through him, because he always lives to intercede for them. My God, God is always on the post waiting to rescue his child, or send his angels. Come on here, somebody, to send his angels to safeguard over us, to watch and to keep us. The Bible also declares for us to be the light. And you know my translation of being the light is this: be the glow. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, purifies us from all sin. That's 1 John 1:7. If you go on down to verse 9, it says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. So in other words, that victory that we're proclaiming, that we're saying we have victory over sin, yes, we do. I've just backed it up with the Word of God. These scriptures make it abundantly clear that God desires for all of his children to experience a victorious life. We must place our faith and our trust in God, and he will give us the victory. God will give us the victory. Now I can go ahead and flow into matters of the heart. And so in matters of the heart, I was wanting to express to you about, you know, those giants, the life giants, the giants that we face, the giants that make us fearful. God will defeat every giant that you encounter. God wants you to live a life of faith and victory. He already knows that you will be faced with trials and temptations of many kinds. He know the things that so easily get us off course, and, or as they say, that easily beset us. You know, nothing catches God by surprise. We may be shocked. You know, sometimes we can even be crushed, pressed, persecuted, and all of those things. And so was Jesus. You know, some things we just have to put into perspective for a moment, just to think, you know, just to have that moment to just kind of reflect and think about some things. Know that you can think about some things that God has brought you through. And he brought you through them. You might have felt scarred, burned, you know, like they say, you know, you walk through the fire and you've come out and don't even smell like smoke. Don't even look like what you've been through. Don't even look like that you've been, you know, for chemo treatments, or you've been through radiation. Don't even look like what you're going through, because you're proclaiming victory every step of the way. You are a word walker. Walk the word. You are a faith talker. Talk the word. Be the word. Be the glow. Be the light. He assures us. Jesus gave us an example of how to use the authority of the Bible to stand strong in the midst of trials and temptations. In the New Testament book of Matthew, we read about how Jesus was even tempted by the devil. He himself was tempted. Jesus was led, you know, by the Holy Spirit into the desert. This is the story where he fasted for 40 days and 40 nights, and he was hungry. He was physically and emotionally at a very weak point. And that's when the devil came to tempt him. So now if Jesus was tempted, again, the devil tempted Jesus by commanding him to turn the stones into bread. The story is found in Matthew. It's found in the book of Matthew. I was pausing to look for the chapter and the verse, but it's in Matthew when Jesus was tempted by the devil. So, you know, if Jesus was, again, if he was tempted, who are we Why are we going to be exempt? We won't. But how do we fight that? How do we know that we can overcome it? It's through the word. So rather than argue or debate with the devil, Jesus, what he did was he just quoted God's word because he know that God's word is true. And so that's what I'm trying to say to you on tonight. God's word is true today, tonight, depending on which time zone you're in. But his word is true. Listen, the devil cannot deny truth or overcome it. The devil cannot deny truth, nor can he overcome it. He cannot succeed in that area. So all we have to do is speak truth. And again, the truth is the word of God. And when you are tried and tempted by the devil, when the devil rise up against you and come up against you, all you have to tell him is say, but it is written. It is written in the word of God. God's word has promised me this. The anthem of the believer, hallelujah, the anthem of the believer is that Christ won the victory over death. And he did that so that we can have life and have it more abundantly, so that we can be healed from sickness and disease, and that we can overcome the obstacles that he may try to trip us up with and he may throw our way, just so that we won't live in peace. So God will defeat life's giants. He will. Those things that seem unbearable to you, those goals that may seem unreachable, Jesus already did it. Defeat was already defeated. Was already defeated. What a mighty God that we serve. We serve a mighty God who loves us. If we look at Psalm 85, it says, you have made them a little lower than the angels and crowned them with glory and honor. You made them rulers over the work of your hands, over the works of your hands. You put everything under their feet, all flocks and herds and the animals of the wild, the birds in the sky and the fish in the sea, all that swim the paths of the sea. Over all of that, man has been crowned with glory and honor. We are more than conquerors. And listen to this. We win regardless of the circumstances. We win regardless of the circumstances. God did all of that. Isn't it amazing? After he had done all of that, crowned you with glory, said you are his beloved. Oh my God. And then say, you have the victory. Run your race. I've got you. Fear not. I am in control. All you have to do is believe. Believe that you can receive those things of the heart. When your heart is towards God, pleasing God, loving people, serving others, you are destined to win. You are destined to win. So that's the matters of the heart for you in this segment. God will help you to defeat life's giants. Think about it. 2 Timothy 1 chapter verse 7 says, for God have not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Knowing the word of God fuels you. You will gain the strength like David did as he rose up against Goliath. Oh, you know the story. Mm-hmm. When he defeated the giant. Yeah. Because David knew where his strength came from. He knew that he would be able to take him out. Not because of the rock. Not because of that, but because of the belief that he had in the man who created the rock, who created him, who said that he was a winner. David linked up to that same anointing, and so can you. God will help you defeat life's giants.
Let's go! Come on!
Catch the show replay of Destiny Talk with Lady Cook on our podcast at Spreaker.com. Listen up. Here's our May events. The Mental Health Awareness Forum will take place on Tuesday, May 14th at 6:30 p.m. Find out additional information on our Facebook pages, Lady Cook Ministry pages, or from the website. Join the Destiny Walkers for a day out on Saturday, May 18th. You are invited to join us for a day of entertainment and fellowship at our host location, Church of Kingdom of Zion Ministries. They will put on the production Glory Train. Tickets and donations are $10. The location is 131 Parkview Drive in Harbison, Columbia, South Carolina, 29212. For more information, you can call Kingdom of Zion Ministries at 803-749-1493. June 8th is Glow Day, also known as Wear Your Pearls to Support Women's Empowerment. We will also celebrate that day with a prayer breakfast at 10 a.m. at our Harbison Church location, the Kingdom of Zion Ministries. Again, that location is 131 Park Ridge Drive in Columbia, South Carolina. The next Destiny Walkers Women Empowerment Forum will be June the 11th at 6:30 p.m., a meet and greet social with Lady Cook, a time of inspiration and fellowship at our Northeast Church location, which is the Crossings Community Church, 2831 Clemson Road in Columbia, South Carolina. Lady Cook Ministries and the Destiny Walkers were launching their Team Fayetteville. Our first interest meeting will be Saturday, June 15th at 2 p.m. at the Sandpiper Seafood Restaurant in Fayetteville, North Carolina. Come out to find out information about the ministry and how you can help us continue to enlarge our territories. Remember, the hashtag is Women's Empowerment, Casting the Nets, Enlarging Our Territories. Contact Lady Cook for bookings and to stay connected on all of our upcoming events, as well as sow a love seed into the ministry at www.ladycookministries.org, or you can cash app that to the $ Lady Cook Ministries. Catch the glow and shine into your destiny. Okay, here we are. We're at our empowering moments. We have, we're looking at victory in Jesus. Victory in Jesus. Listen, you were never created to walk in defeat. You were created to win. And I'm going to talk to you about a few steps on how you can walk in victory. Okay? Don't allow fear to hold you back. Keep stretching, keep growing, and tap into everything that God has placed on the inside of you. Do not be in fear. Fear, doubt, and lack of self-image will hinder your belief. The anointing is what brings restoration to you. It brings supernatural accelerations and victory in every battle. And that was a quote by Bill Winston. Now let's get to the steps on how to walk in victory. There's four steps. The first step is that we must continue to have a fellowship with Jesus. We must maintain a continuous fellowship with the Lord through the reading of His Word and through prayer. Prayer is our greatest privilege, but it can also be our biggest failure. We've got to learn how to discipline ourselves to stay before God, to stay in the Word of God and pray and meditate. Pray on those things that concern you. We are to cast all of our anxieties and our cares on our God. The second step is that we must continually trust in Jesus. We must always trust in God, even when we don't see His hand at work. And, you know, we just got to trust and know that many times that God is just working behind the scenes, that He's working it all out. He's going to work it together for your good. God will always answer prayers with a yes or no. And then it could be a time that He may tell you not yet. He may just tell you to wait. But you got to continuously trust Him and be in commune with Him to know. The third thing is that we must always maintain a oneness with God. We must maintain a oneness with Him. God deserves our praise that He deserves. You know, He deserves our worship. He deserves our praise. We are a reflection of Jesus and should be walking in love and in truth. We should be walking as ambassadors, victorious ambassadors of Christ. That's who we are. And the fourth step to victory is that we must maintain a witness for God. Be a witness for Him. Tell of His goodness. Tell of His mercy. Tell some, you know, we are overcome by the words of our testimony. Talk with one another. Encourage one another. We've got to, you know, we've got to get that discipleship piece, you know, active. We got to make sure we keep it active in our lives because, you know, the devil will try to remind you of all kind of stuff. He'll try to, you know, throw your past at you every opportunity that's availed to him. But we've got to stay a witness before Christ and we've got to, you know, we've got to declare his word and we've got to say, look, I've been made over by the blood of the Lamb. I've been crucified with Christ. I've got to walk in my newness. I've got to embrace who I am. This is who I am. Lest I remind you, come on here. Lest I remind you that he done brought me through some things. And I know that I know that I know that if it had not been, come on, if it had not been for his grace and mercy, if it had not been for his love for me, sometimes you just got to remind yourself and then tell of his, you know, then tell of his goodness. We are who we are. We strive in this daily walk. We do. We strive sometimes just to make it, you know, just to make it to lie down and just to rest in peace, you know, in peaceful thoughts and, you know, just to have peace in our homes and just to say, God, you know, I thank you for the day. It's been a rough day, but I still lift my heart and I still lift my hands to praise towards you for who you are in my life. I'm alive because of who you are. So I challenge you to come alive in the word of God. Be rich in the word of God. Proclaim your status as victorious. Be who God has called you to be and watch God work all things out for your good. This is our last song for tonight. I'll come back with closing remarks.
You are, you are, you are my freedom. Feel it too.
so glad to be alive in Christ. We are alive in Christ. Let me just, before I go into my closing remarks, I want to say thank you to the team. They always make sure that I stay straight in the word and make sure I get this information out to you. Destiny listeners, when I was speaking about Satan tempting Jesus, it's actually recorded in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke. And so you can find that in the fourth chapter of Matthew, verses 1 through 11. Because I know those of you who are out there listening, and to our Facebook audience as well, and all of those who are hearing the platform of Power and Praise Radio. Again, that's just to bring some more clarity and define where you can find where Jesus was tempted for the 40 days and 40 nights in the wilderness, as recorded in the Gospels, Matthew 4, 1 through 11. And now here's to my closing remarks. I actually have three summary points to leave with you as you continue to lean in to the voice of God, which is the Word of God, that will enable you to defeat the giants, that will enable you to defeat life's giants that will arise up against you. The first lesson that I want to leave with you of the summary point is that you must recognize that you cannot fight sin alone. Even Jesus needed the strength and the wisdom of God's word. Jesus responded by speaking the truth. So, be reminded to speak the truth. Get in the word. Activate that faith. Activate that word within your life. The second summary point is that you must submit yourself to the authority of God's word. You cannot fight your spiritual enemies by your own authority, for you have no authority. But when you appeal to God's word, then you stand by the greatest authority, one that has no equal. He has no equal. There's no rival. And the third summary point is that the devil knows God's word. Yes, he does. And he will twist it to lie to you. So be careful and cautious of the things that come to you and how you filter things in your mind. Flush it all out. Make it all even. Base it all on the word of God. Give substance to it. Give life to it. Make sure that it rings true so that it don't, make you, slumber and fall, or put you into, a mental handicap. Where you would, experience the fear and the stress and the things that the devil do use against, to fight against you, to kill and destroy you. So we've got to make sure that we know the word, know the Bible, and know when the enemy is trying to use it against us, when he's trying to fight, to use God's word incorrectly in an effort to, trick you or to fool you into believing something that is not. So you got to be active in the word of God, active in the word of God. And then that way you will know immediately, of those false teachings or the sayings or the things that come up against you to try to trap you up and to keep you from experiencing victory in every area of your life. And so for someone that may want to receive the salvation and may want to receive this victory, how will God equip you to walk in victory? You are equipped as you read the Bible every day and you receive his salvation. And this is the salvation that is for you, is that if you don't know Christ and you want to be saved, you read and recite Romans chapter 10, verse 9, which says, if you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Amen. So contact us through the Lady Cook Ministries website. We would love to send you information on your salvation. All you have to do is go to the website, www.ladycookministries.org, and click on Pray For Me or contact us, and put your information and your email address in there, and we'll make sure that we send you the information that you need on your salvation. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. And my closing thought is this: if God be for us, who can be against us? Romans 8 and 31. All right. So, Destiny listeners, tune in next week. Is it next week? Nope, it's not next week. It's Tuesday, May 21st, for Destiny Talk with Lady Cook, right here on Power and Praise, broadcasting from Sumter, South Carolina, 6 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Until then, much love, much power, and much grace.
right, everybody. Here we go again. Time to lift them up. Come on, get up on your feet. Come on, everybody, let's lift them up.
Jesus,
oh yeah, yeah.
Jesus,
He's my healer,
Jesus,
my strong.